Hello and welcome to this webinar on hourly rates and indexation, the release we released yesterday. My name is Christopher Landstorp and I'm the head of product management in TimeLog and responsible for the development of our products. Today we will go through the new things and the changes and how you can benefit from the new release. If you have questions along the way, feel free to write them in the chat box. I have my assistant here that will take a look at them, and if we have the time in the end, we will take some of them and give some answers. And if we don't have time for it, we will get back to you by email after the seminar. Let's get started. So today we'll see a live demo of the new hourly rates model. And we'll also take a look on how you can use our intelligent hourly rate suggestion to make sure that your data quality is better and avoid to have to clean up data. Then we'll take a look at the new indexation feature in the end as well. We'll sum up the demo with some key takeaways, and then we'll give you a few advice on how to proceed with the new release to get the maximal benefit from the release. And in the end, we'll take some Q&A if we have the time for it. But I will focus on the demonstration and not rush through it. So we will see in the end about that. But let's get to it. So here I have my TimeLog demo environment, and we'll start off in the price lists. So we haven't changed anything inside our price lists. They work, how you create them and handle them works the same way. If we look at this site here, we have a setup with the 7 hourly rates, and we have two price groups, one for Denmark in Danish krona and one from Sweden in Swedish krona. This is our standard hourly rates. This is the prices we want all new projects to have by default. So the change we did for price list is that when you do price list changes in the previous system, they were reflected directly onto the projects. But that direct connection between projects and price list gave a lot of problems in terms of being able to modify hourly rates on your projects so they fitted your project pricing or your project agreement with the customer. So what happens today is that when we create a new project, we copy the prices that you have in the price list to the new project. So let's see how that works. Do a new project here. We'll do some naming here. Pick my customer. I've chosen the Danish price group, and it's a simple time and material project. Here is the new project, and we go to the contract and look. As we can see in the contract, we have now got a new tab called hourly rates. In the tab, you see a copy of the price list completely as it was right now. The great thing about copying the hourly rates to the project is that I'm now free to modify the prices here so it fits to this specific projects. For example, I can go in, I have agreed with the customer that programming should only cost 1,000 kroner for this project. I can also, disable or hide hourly rates I don't want to use on the project by clicking the eye. They get inactive and are not appearing in the lists. I can see them again here and activate them again. And I can even remove them if I really want to get rid of them so they are not used for anything if I don't need them in the project. I can also, if I have specific hourly rates that I need for this project that is not in my price list, I can simply create a new hourly rate on the fly. I can say my project hourly rate here, and I can give it a price of 300. If product numbers is used on hourly rates, I'll have to add that Then I have three options down here. I can either add this hourly rate just for this project. I can add the hourly rate to the standard price list, so I can actually build my standard price list from my projects if I want to. And I can add hourly rates to the customer specific price list. So now I have added the my project hourly rate here for this project. If I now go and just to see how that works and try to add a resource here, we can see in the dropdown that we have 300 my project hourly rate and programming is 1000. So the hourly rates we use in the project now is from the specific hourly rates on the project and not from the price list. But what about customer price lists? So returning to our price list structure here in finance, in the hourly rates, we have the ability to create special pricing for specific customers. So if we want to have a special price for this customer, I can go and create a customer price list. By default, the customer price list is the same as the standard price list. But now I can go in and I can modify specific hourly rates where I made some special pricing for this customer. So if I want for this customer, we agreed that they should only pay $1,200 for project management, I can change that. We can now see that it's marked that it's different from the standard pricing. It's important to say that a big difference here from the existing or the previous version is that when we create a project from a customer price list, now you copy these hourly rates and you don't get the standard hourly rates. So you should only do a customer price list if this is how you want all new projects for that customer to be priced by default. I can also create a customer hourly rate that do not exist in the standard price list, but only for this customer. Again, this will then appear on all new projects for the customer, and you still need to pick a product number if that is part of your setup. So let's try and see now. I changed the project management to 1200 and did my special customer price here. Let's try and make a customer project. Select my customer. And we again select Denmark as the price group. If we go now and look on the new customer project here on the contracts and look at the hourly rates, we see I have my special customer hourly rate here at 300, and we can see that project management is created at as 1200. So again, emphasizing that all projects in the future I create for this customer will have this specific hourly rate. A note on that is that if you have now a lot of hourly rates for your in your customer price list and you want to clean it up, you go into the list view and you expand here. You can use, you need to pick the customer hourly rate first, the custom price list, and you expand the list. You can go use this arrow to reset the hourly rate back to standard. So you don't, if you don't want this price for all new customer projects, go in and reset it to the standard hourly rate. One of the nice thing about this specific hourly rate you can create on a project is that you can, for example, create it on the fly here when you do new projects or you are in existing projects. Then you can say project standard price. So let's say I want one here for 900. So this is a special price I want on this project for all to be suggested by default for anything in the project. So by setting this, I created it on the fly here. it's already automatic pushed to the pricing of the project. So this way, when I create a project that just need 1 hourly rate, I can actually create it together with the project, or I can go in afterwards and create it here. So that was another place that is really convenient compared to today is if I use the prepaid contract, where this is the contract. If your customer purchase a lot of hours up front, and then they get a discount. For that, you might get some special prices. So let's say that I have agreed that they pay 875 krona an hour because they purchased 100 hours up front. Today, in the previous system, when you did these kind of hourly rates, they were pushed to the price list. And if you have a lot of prepaid contracts, you will get a lot of hourly rates that appeared in your price lists and were available in all contracts. Now this prepaid contract only will have this hourly rate. We can see it here, prepaid, and I can actually go in and simply remove anything I don't need for this project here. What we see is I'm not allowed to delete the standard price that I put on the project because I need to have that as a reference for other stuff. So here was a few scenarios where it would be great. You can just create your hourly rate on the fly, and it's only inside this project, and it doesn't pollute our standard pricing, either the standard hourly rates or the customer hourly rates. This is the basic of our new feature for the hourly rate model, how you use the price list to create new projects and how you on the projects can control the specific, align your pricing on your project to your agreement with the customer without having to do new hourly rates for your price lists. So just a short note on how can you utilize our intelligent hourly rate suggestion. So first of all, for an employee, we have a default hourly rate. This is the hourly rate we would like to be suggested when we allocate this employee. But we can specify inside our project more specifically if we want the employee to be suggested to other hourly rates in specific scenarios. As we saw before, we had put on this project, we had put a special hourly rate, standard hourly rate. It means that no matter the employee's hourly rate, when you allocate any employee to this project, use this price. I will now deselect this so I can show you the other options. So if we go in now and look here, and this employee that has project management as the default, we can see now I'm suggested with project management when I allocate. Sometimes I might have a task that I want specific pricing on, no matter who tracks time on it. That could be travel time. We invoice that at a lower rate. So I want a specific hourly rate for travel time. So looking here again and see the for the customer normal task, you will get the employee's default hourly rate suggested, or and for travel time you will get the specific hourly rate there. Then just returning to this to make the point clear again, if I go in and choose 900 as the standard and try to allocate, we can now see for this employee, now it's no longer the employee standard hourly rate, but the 900 for the project that is taken instead. You can also in the resource group set which hourly rate an employee is to work on a given project, if it's not the employee standard hourly rate. We have made a change here. We have made it so that when you suggest a new resource, say, see here, we have this is the anonymized data, so it looks a little bit crazy. We have now changed it so that no default hourly rate is suggested. If you want the employee to be suggested with the default hourly rate they have on the card, you should just let this be. But if you want to deviate from the employee's standard hourly rate, you can do so. So if I now say this funny employee should not work for the 800 I defined on the project, because he's a junior, he should work with an hourly rate of 300. So now I add this resource to my project, and you can see here it has a default of 300. This means that if I go in now and choose this employee is suggested with 300 for the normal task that elsewise would be suggested with 900, the project specific hourly rate, and travel time sticks still 625. And the standard employee is still for 900. So you can use these levels when you want to deviate from the employee's default hourly rate in the suggestion. That means that if you always want the standard hourly rate, you don't set anything, but then you can set one for the project if everything on the project should have the same price. And then lower in the hierarchy, you can go in and say, yes, but we have the standard hourly rate, but we want on this specific task a specific price, or we want some employee to deviate specifically from the other things. By setting this up, you will correctly from the start, you will not by default or by mistake allocate with the wrong hourly rate. And if you even let your employees track time and find their own task, this will happen in the right way if they are put the setup is correct from start. And all this suggestion will follow the pricing for the specific project. So if you change the pricing, then the pricing is also changed here in the setup. That was all for the hourly rate model and a little bit about how you can utilize our intelligent suggestion. So you don't need to pick hourly rates all the time when you allocate people, and you save yourself from getting data that will be corrupt and you need to clean and change. Let's grab a look at our new feature, how to index hourly rates. This is the default, this is the interface you get to when you go to the indexation. We have two options here. In the top, we have an option to index by percentage, which means that all hourly rates in the project will be lifted with the percentage you add, or you can do it by amount, where you control how the change of the specific hourly rates are pushed. For example, if I have an hourly rate of 1,000, I want to be 1,015 instead of 2.1%. Then I can control that specifically through the indexation in amount. But let's try and index here in percentage first. So I just want to take a look at the project I'm going to show you first. So let's just look at the price list before we do anything. We go back to the project and look at how is the hourly rates here. We can see we have an invoice design of 800, we have programming of 1100, and the standard price of 900. So if we go and take this customer, you can see over here we have three options. We can do it on a customer level, on a project level, or down to the contract level. But if I just know that one customer, I need to do the indexation for all the projects across the customer, I can use this one. So I will click show, and I'll get a list that fits the search criteria I put up. Here we can see the customer with customer prices. There is one project for that customer, and I want to index it 5%, just for us to have it easy to calculate. Then I click index. When I click index, I need to select when this indexation takes effect. And this is very important. So you can only push an indexation back in time. So you can't schedule it into the future. This means that if you want to index 1st of January, you should make sure that all time registration and all periods are closed for the time in December, all the way up to the date you want to index. So you can wait until mid-January or now in the end of January, because when you say you want to index, I can do it from 1st of January. And this means that all time registrations from 1st of January and forward is going to have the new hourly rates indexation I'm pushing. But it's also important to say that if you, after you have done the indexation, go back and track time before the indexation date, it will use the new hourly rates. So make sure to close your period before you do indexation. It doesn't matter that you for a while use the old prices, because you can use the indexation period to catch up for the new prices. But we click save and now it index. This is done very fast because we only have one project, but if you had multiple, it will queue it and process it along the way. Let's go back to the project and reload and see what has been done. So now we look down the hourly rates and we can see that invoice designs was changed from 800 to 840, 1100 to 1155 and so on. All has been raised with 5%. We can go to the project plan and we can see that when I allocate an employee, we can see now the price list is the indexed hourly rates. I can also see on the task that my travel time has been indexed to the new hourly rate. So from now on and forward, all time registration created or updated will use these new hourly rates that I used for indexing. Let's take a look at the other way of indexing the amount indexation. Again, let's just very quickly look at the hourly rates here in the project. We have an invoice design 800 and we have a project management of 1300. So I go into my indexation in amount, and the first thing I need to do is to select my price list. Now I want to index my standard hourly rates, but I could also go and choose my customer hourly rates price list and index that. I want to index the Danish prices, and then I click show here and get a list of these. Now I don't want a percentage, some kind of odd number. I want a specific number. I want this one to go to 812, and I want the 1300 to go to 1325. So I just want to change these two and not the rest. Now I go in and I get my choice of how to sort which projects I want to index. This one time I want to index this customer. Again, I do it on the customer. I can do it on the customer level here. There's only one project, and I choose to index that and say that is from the 1st of January 2020. And it was also processed very fast here. So let's try and reload the project here and see what has been done. And we can now see that invoice design has an hourly rate of 812 and project management is 1325, while the others have not been changed. So this is the two options you have when you index in TimeLog, with indexation in percentage and indexation in amount. Then I want to do a note on a very important thing. I just need to get the data. Here we can see an example of two contracts. And we can see over here the date called last indexation. I actually, in my test yesterday, indexed this contract here. So the risk when you index is that you might do double indexation. You start Monday and then you got busy and didn't complete, and you go on Wednesday, you continue, and you by mistake index what you did on Monday. To avoid that, in our filter, we'd have put in this last indexation date before. So if I go in now and put 21 or something before, let's say I started Monday with this, and I show the result again, you can see now the last indexation, the one that was indexed after the 20 of January is now gone. So when you index, make sure to keep this date correct. So when you start, keep that date there. And before you click index, you could just double check down the latest indexation list to make sure that you are not indexing something you already indexed this week or this round. So this is how we want to ensure for you that that you don't get to double index things. Also, if you have a long list, you check mark those you want to index. You can condense it down to the ones you have selected by clicking this checkbox, show selected only. With that, we have concluded the walkthrough of the new features, which I hope you will enjoy. So just to sum up with some key takeaways you should be aware of. The price list are now templates for hourly rates in the new project. For customers that do not have a customer specific or customer price list, you will get the standard hourly rates. If a customer has a customer price list, that will be the change or the hourly rate you get. So make sure your customer price list reflect what you want projects for this specific customer to be next time you create a project for the customer. You can control the project pricing without messing up the price list now, which has been a big challenge for some of our customers, that when you wanted a special price on your project, you would get a list that grew with a lot of project specific hourly rates that was also available on other projects. But now changing the amount simply on the project or adding special prices on the project will not mess up your price lists anymore. And make sure you don't get faulty hourly rates in your other projects. Also with this, our intelligent hourly rate suggestion works better because by just simply changing the amount on one of your standard hourly rates, it will keep on suggesting that one for your employee. Before, if you did a customer hourly rate to because you needed it on the project, it would never be chosen as a suggestion because it was not a standard hourly rate for the employee. So now you can better utilize all our setup around hourly rates to make sure that you don't get time registrations with the wrong hourly rate on that you need to fix when you invoice or go back and change all the allocations, etc. So spending a few moments getting familiar with our options here, I think will help you in your future when you work with projects. You can index now in two different ways. You can use the percentage if you simply want to update all the hourly rate with a specific percentage. You can do it in amount if you want to control exactly how you change the amount. And remember, you can do this on three levels. You can do it on project, which means that you can do it across all the projects for the customer. You can do it, on the customer level. You can do it on project, where you do it across all contracts on the project, and you can go down to the specific contract and do it there. Make sure when you index to use the date filter so you don't risk of double indexing, and also just take a quick look down the last index date before you click the indexation. Running off with a few advices now, how do you proceed? If you are a system administrator, we urge you to go into your custom price lists and clean them up so they reflect how you want the customer's next project to be priced. You can remove all the custom hourly rates that you created for specific projects that should not be used anymore. And you can reset all the overwritten hour standard hourly rates if you want to revert back to the standard pricing for that customer. This way you stand with a customer price list that reflects your actually set up for that customer for the next project. As a project manager, we urge you to go through your existing time and material contracts. Maybe you can remove irrelevant hourly rates that might come from other projects in your customer price list. And you can also, maybe if you haven't got the correct pricing, you could simply adjust all your hourly rates now to reflect the agreement with the customer, ensuring that you get the right pricing on your time registrations. So I think now we have a little time for some Q&A. Do we have some no questions here? Okay, so we have simply no questions asked so far. If you have one while I advertise for the next webinar, let me know. Well, also here we will send you this PowerPoint. There are some helpful links where you can read more about the release, and there are some videos again on the whole hourly rate model and the indexation you can follow. You can also in general follow our release notes and our development plans on our help center. The link is here, but you could also just go to help.timelog.com and find it under release and development plans. If you follow, for example, our under development, you will get notified every time we change it, so you in good time can see what is coming up next from our development. We also offer 3 hours workshop with a consultant. If you would like to have that and help you clean up your system and set it up optimally and understand the possibilities, write an email to Samina and she will get back to you very shortly. The last thing, we have a question here. So we'll do that before we talk about that. I can just announce this and then we'll turn to the questions. So we have a webinar on this February 6th from 9 to 10, where our CEO, Per-Henrik Nielsen, will tell you about how he's going to drive changes in TimeLog for 2020, where are we going with the company and the product. And I will also present you with a preview of our new UI experience, which we are launching in 2020. We are working with a very skilled UXer to make the UI experience much better in TimeLog and also change the design to a more modern way. So you have a chance to see this and how this is going to, how you are going to transition into this in a very nice and personal way. Yeah, there's a user rights question. Like, thank you for that. Actually, something I forgot. Actually, today we just launched a little bit extension to this release. Now you can inside the rights management, if you go into roles, for example, here I have a project manager role, and I go to the section projects. We have now added this section called to control who can create hourly rates on your project. So here you can decide if the person that has this role can create hourly rates directly from the project. You can even say which level that they can create for the specific project, but not push them to the price lists. I have a question: if the registered hours, registered hourly rate for the chosen consultant and projects follow to the task when you divide projects by task and phase? Yes, it is so that if you don't define a standard hourly rate on the task, it will look first to the resource group, then to the project, and in the end, the employee's default hourly rate to find the right hourly rate for the employee. So if you set a specific hourly rate for the project, this is what is suggested for all tasks that do not have a specific pricing and all employees that do not have a specific pricing inside the resource group. Why does the indexing of pricing go back before the front date? It does make sense to me. What is the front date used for? So just jumping back into this indexation here. The date here is to avoid double indexation. This means that if I started indexing on Monday, which is the 20th, having this date here will make sure that any project or contract or hourly rate I indexed on the 20th or later will not be indexed. I can still make the indexation take effect before this date. So I can make the changes on the hourly rates and the time registrations from 1st of January, but I performed the indexation on the 20th. So when I'm sitting and working on multiple days in a row for indexation, I know I started on the 20th. So anything I've done on the 20th and later, I should not redo. So it's a way of making sure you don't index something you already indexed in this round where you did indexation. But when it takes effect is what you control when you click the last button and the pop-up. And a question, what happens with the registered hours or time that has not been invoiced before the price indexation? So if you are indexing on the 1st of January, anything before the 1st of January will keep its old pricing, even though it has not been indexed, invoiced. So we will only change time registrations from the date going forward from the 1st of January, if that's the day you choose. So anything before that will not change at all and keep the hourly rates. But remember, the allocations, the default hourly rates, they are indexed as well. So if you update these before the date, they will get the new pricing, which is why it's very important that you make sure the timesheets or the accounting period is closed so the employees cannot update these registrations. There's a lengthy question here. I need to just read it. Sorry. Yeah, it's a little lengthy, but if you do a price change in your price list and you want to push it to some specific project, you can do so through the amount indexation. I'll just give you a short example. If I go here to my standard price list and my 2020 pricing for let's just see it here in matrix easier, for invoice design has changed in general. So I go in and I edit this. So it changed to 850 and to 950 here. Save. Now, if I go to the indexation in amount and I choose my standard hourly rate here, we can see that the 850 is now the new pricing. Now I can simply choose all of them and say, now I want to push this. And I can choose the specific customer and so on that I want to push this for. It also means that you can actually push it to, not, you don't need to push it to all. You can do so by simply don't having a filter and then choose all, but you can also do it to those you want to push the new pricing to. Maybe you have something that started up in December that you cannot change the pricing on. With this new model, that you actually have this flexibility to select which projects that needs to be updated with this new pricing. Another question, can we avoid decimals? We haven't yet implemented a way to do rounding. It will be something we probably will extend on later on. So in the percentage indexation, you would be able to say you don't want decimals, but there will also be an option maybe to round to the lowest, below 5 or up 5 or up 10 and low 10. You can control it though through the amount indexation, because here you can say, okay, I have these prices now, and when I index it, I need them to go to the specific hourly rates. It's a little bit more cumbersome, we understand that, and we would like to do the other option later on, but for now, this is your option. If you don't want decimals or percentage, use the amount indexation to control the precise amount getting onto the project and contracts. There's a question if there's any specific cleanup we need to do on existing projects. You're not required to do anything, but now you have the option to actually remove hourly rates that are not relevant for the project. This means that if you have, for example, a lot of customer hourly rates created over time, that is from different projects, those projects, they are not relevant on. You can simply go into the contract and remove them so you don't, by mistake, use them. You can also adjust your pricing as is now. If you want to change the standard prices and use those instead of some special prices you created, so the suggestions works better with your employees' default hourly rate. Is it possible to inactivate current customer prices? Yes, it is. And that's why I suggest that you go into the system administration and your customer price list and make sure it looks like you want the next project for this customer to look like. So if we go into the customer price list I created here, and you see the special price I created for this customer, I can go in simply and say deactivate on this. And now when I create a new project, this hourly rate do not appear anymore. If this overwritten price is not correct anymore, you can of course adjust it, or you can simply click the arrow here to revert it back to the standard price. So now I actually have a customer price list that looks exactly like the standard pricing list, and that can be removed as well. So there's again, there's a rounding question. Will the percentage indexation round? No, it will not right now. The only option we have to control the specific amount is to go through the amount indexation. So if you want to index 1150 with 5%, you get a decimal point. The only way to avoid this is to go into that price list and say the 1150 should be turned into the specific one you want. So if all only those that if only registrations from the start date is affected, why do I need to close my registrations from before? You need to do so because when you index your project change pricing, that means that on your task, when I track time here, my allocation actually gets a new hourly rate. And we have not locked down an indexation date. So when you track time, it understands if it's before and after the indexation. It simply uses the hourly rate that is currently on your task and your allocation. And as that is the indexed price, tracking time before the indexation will also use the new pricing. This is why you need to close it to ensure that you don't get the new prices on old registrations. If I deactivate a price in the price list, will it be deactivated on the project as well? Right now, that is not the situation. You can, in a few days, we are aiming to release so that you can delegate this change out to your project. So deactivating, creating new hourly rates and deleting hourly rates in the price list will be delegated out to your projects. But for now, that is not the case. But you can also choose not to do it, and then it will go on in your project and live until you close the project. So you have the freedom of changing your price list without affecting the projects now. So you, if you want to do a new price list, completely clean it out, you can actually do so and then just have your existing projects run with the current pricing until they are done. So all new projects run with new pricing. The time is over now. And if you have more questions, feel free to call our support or write questions to Samin. We will support you the best way we can. This PowerPoint will go out shortly to you. There are some links, helpful links there in it. And we really look forward to getting your feedback. We will listen to your feedback and we'll also do adjustment of this in the next period and along the way. So now we are excited to hear if this helps you and what is good and bad, let us know and we'll do our best to serve you and make sure that this turns to be a really, really nice release for you that helps you in your daily work. Thank you for now. Have a nice day. Goodbye.